Hello, I'm Paul Zajicek, founder of Elastic Steel, Master of Athletic Conditioning. Today I'm going to expand on the video that I did about a week ago, and in that video we talked about adductors and abductors, how they're related in terms of injury and pain. Today I'm going to talk about the adductors, which is the muscles right here, the inner side, mostly some more forward, some more back, and how they're related to the low back. Some of those questions have been coming up, and I said I'm going to make a video about it. Now, the abduction is about 45 to 50 degrees. 48 degrees, some people can do about 35 degrees, and I'm talking about healthy movement. You don't have an inflammation there that's severely restricting, and you don't have the stretch joint capsule where you can go more. The normal range of motion, which is about 45, 48 degrees, about here. This is what it is. And I did that without moving my pelvis. If I move my pelvis, that means that I'm getting the stretch from this leg, from adductors on this side, from hamstring on that side, then the leg goes high. Now, how is the adductors related to low back pain? Well, it's only 45 degrees, but if you can only bring it up 20 degrees, it matters because you're lacking about 25 degrees. So if you bring it here and you want to throw a kick, what you have to do is you have to get that severe movement from your pelvis. In other words, your pelvis shifts and you get a lot of abduction with the outward rotation on this side. Okay, now why is that a problem if you can do that? Well, technically it's not a problem, but your kick is going to look like this. And if your kick looks like that, and you're trying to keep your body up, the only way you can keep your body up is by flexing and rotating your spine, usually your lower back, and most of that happens in your lower back for a lot of people. We can do stuff with our middle back, but most people try to go with the lower back. So what ends up happening is when you throw kick, especially in sparring, especially when you throw that kick, try to follow up with a punch, you try not to drop that trunk. Severely flex your body to the side, you rotate your body a little bit. When you do that, what do you get? You get spasms all over the place here. Your obliques, your abdominals on that side, your lower back, especially your lower back, and you get the stretch in the opposite side. Okay? Now, if you don't do it and you kick like this and your body hangs this way, if you're not ready for it, if you're not trained for it, your body is hanging here, you're not used to this position, you still might get an injury. The leg doesn't abduct completely. Pelvis compensates, the body goes over to the side. We try to flex as much as possible. Now, if you don't have that flexibility to flex that much, some people do. However, keep in mind, if somebody doesn't have the flexibility in their adductors, what are the chances they're gonna have good flexibility in their lateral flexes? What I see is the opposite. Good flexibility here, poor flexibility in lateral flexes. It usually does not happen that somebody has good lateral flexibility and at the same time, they cannot abduct their leg completely. Usually it's the other way around. Okay, but someone can abduct the leg, chances are they're not going to be able to flex. So when they do flex, to pull the body in that direction against the resistance of the other side, that's cramps. If you do it too fast, you might tear or injure something on the other side. Now, there are many different reasons why somebody might have lower back pain while performing the kicks or performing similar movements. If you look at Elastic Steel channel, you'll see a few different videos that talk about different reasons. So you can't just look at this and say, well, I think this is mine. That's for your therapist to decide, or maybe your doctor, orthopedic surgeon, maybe a chiropractor, physical therapist, maybe even a trainer. It's for them to decide what the problem is. However, it's one of the possible reasons. I'm Paul Zajicek. Thank you.